Basically, the project started at Virginia Tech with Conservation Management Institute back in 2005. Jeff Walden had the idea, and we began looking at the opportunity to develop switchgrass as a biofuel for use in the state of Virginia. Our ultimate goal was to get about 50,000 acres of grass planted primarily to enhance quail habitat.
The thing that I like about what we've been doing at Burkeville is it's a combined project that addresses the need for the hospital there to reduce their costs, reduce their greenhouse gas emissions to address some of the sustainability goals that they've got, but then also to push more money out into the community, which they have done.
The fuel is fantastic. The statistics that we see off the fuel, BTU values, steam output per ton in this is phenomenal. Greater than we ever expected, than was ever shown in the literature. This project would be absolutely nowhere if it were not for Piedmont Hospital, if it were not for Nottoway County and those people, and the Tobacco Commission, and also FDC and the landowners. And so it's truly a cooperative farm-to-fuel project. Without any peace, it would not exist.
With the fuel oil, the cost fluctuated so much, I would not know from year to year, depending on what the weather was, how much I was going to spend. By using a more consistent cost-based fuel source, the native warm season grass, I've been able to budget more consistently and know what my expenses were going to be from one year to the next.
Sawdust is 40 to 50% water. Switchgrass is under 15% moisture. The way switchgrass became very competitive with sawdust in the wintertime is because of that moisture. You can't burn water. During January of 2011 through February, we had a 44-day successful burn. In the 44-day period, FDC actually put in our economy between $200,000 to $250,000. They stayed in hotels, they ate in Nottoway County in Blackstone, Virginia. They was burning fuel. When the tractors broke down, they were buying materials here. Not only did the FDC put money back into our community, instead of burning oil in those 44 days, we saved $44,000 in those 44 days for the Commonwealth of Virginia.
What we're really talking about is that there's multi-stakeholders and everybody gets a benefit out of it. For landowners, it's a new revenue stream. It's putting land cover on the ground that captures carbon, which is good for everybody. It reduces sedimentation into the streams that are adjacent, which is good for water quality for everybody. We have 10-year contracts, so it's locked in fixed price revenue that's coming into them that they can count on. They can pay their taxes, put some money in the bank, and be able to sustain that heritage that that landowner family may have on that piece of land.
Nottoway Biofuels has offered landowners and farmers another avenue for their unused agricultural land without substituting productive farmland. It has provided a renewable green energy, and it has helped one of our largest employers in the county with their fuel cost. And because that employer is also a state agency, it helps us all as taxpayers.
To see both facilities succeed and grow, if not grow, sustain, and still provide service at cost to the taxpayers of Virginia that they can accept. And they, if they see a program that is not only giving back in other ways, then that protects this campus and the jobs in this community and the local growers that are growing the switchgrass. That's a win for everyone.
Certainly the biofuels focus and the environmental advantages of that was a start, and it is still evolving. The idea that it would be something usefully grown here in Southside Virginia and be a productive crop where other crops like tobacco were no longer viable.
When we first went into this endeavor with FDC, I had to think about the changes that went on in my life from a person that was born in the 60s. When we were growing up, we didn't wear seat belts. And then my children come along and they said, Daddy, you need to put your seatbelt on. And later on, they started recycling, and I thought, I'm not putting all those aluminum cans and taking them somewhere. And they said, but you're saving the earth. And they changed my children, and now I have a granddaughter who's 4 years old, has changed my way of thinking of how we need to take care of our world and for the generations to come. And so that really affected me of saying, to you know, when we started thinking about burning switchgrass, I thought maybe this is something we need to try, at least try, and see what will happen. What's the worst thing could happen? The worst thing could happen, it wouldn't work. But it did work, and we made it work. And we need to figure out how to make things work in the future so these young people can have the environment, can have the pleasure of going outdoors and seeing a pond that's not polluted, a field that's not polluted, and so they can share with their children as I grew up with. And we owe that to the next generation.